When we talk about urban living in the future, we run the risk of portraying something that people don't actually want. Something where they're forced to get on their bicycles, walk to work, don't have any of the luxuries of life, and so on. But, in my view, we can have it all. We can have an efficient, effective, connected urban communities where our homes become as easy to use as a smartphone and we get pleasure every day.
I'm more interested in this concept of massive small. How do we create a big picture within which a million things can happen? And I often refer to two ways of looking at a big picture, or a big picture, a master plan. One could be a colder painting, which has got four or five big splashes on the canvas. And you look at the splashes and you say, wow. And you go back and look at them again and you think, well, okay, I've seen wow. There's nothing more, nothing more unfolds. Whereas you contrast that with, say, a Monet's Water Lilies, which has got a million dabs on the canvas. And you can imagine Monet working on this canvas and saying a bit more yellow, a bit more red. And actually, it's only when the final picture unfolds that the masterpiece is there. And how do we create that million intervention story in the way we do things, rather than this idea of a couple of single big splashes, which we get seduced by quite quickly, but actually we get tired of by the time we've seen it the second and third time.
I think the world which we're moving into, this kind of specialization of urbanity, is going to get much more complex. We're going to re-engage with the non-urban. What do I mean by that? It's the food systems. It's the kind of the different economies. It's the landscapes. It's the ecologies. It's the animal. It's the wildlife. We're getting these hybrid environments. So instead of the big urban kind of tough places, we're actually starting to get these beautiful hybrids. So we're starting to grow more food in our cities. We're starting to have animals. We're starting to have clean water. That's where I think we're going to kind of move. It's not just the urban, it's beyond urban.
And I think if you go and look at historic places, if you look at particulars, I use the example of Shoreditch, those places are amazing purely because the freedom of things exists for things to happen. No one's preordaining what happens. It generally tends to be a response to historic urban fabric that creates that. But how do we create that modern idiom? How do we create that modern way of doing it? I think therein lies the challenge.
I think there are some kind of common rules though for what is good urbanity. It's about convenience, it's about clean air, it's about landscape, it's about community, it's about just being able to do what you enjoy in a community of people.
So when we open this building, the Bush Theatre will be open all day for the first time. We'll have a cafe and we'll have a bar and we'll be inviting the community in, not just when there are performances on. And actually, those spaces, if you get them right, become hugely important, not just to a conversation with the community where they exercise a better sense of ownership and excitement and a sense that it's a permanent fixture in a daily as well as a nightly part of their lives. It's also about finding a way that those spaces become creative, so that you're opening up those rooms, those cafes, those bars, so that artists feel like they can meet there, even if maybe they're not working directly on the show that you've got on. So it becomes a kind of convening point and a meeting point and a point for encounter where ideas can come and grow.
A city and an environment has got to be somewhere that people want to be in. For too long we've had places that people are forced into. You've got to want to be there, first of all. Secondly, you've got to be able to afford to be there. Within the economics of your family group, within the economics of resources in the world, you cannot use too much. You've got to be able to afford to live the lifestyle you can. And finally, and I think the most important things of a new urban environment is that you've got to want to stay there. That's how true cities are made. It's made by building social capital, people investing the most important thing they can in their life. And staying in one place. That's what I think makes good urbanity.